Welcome sa Invest In. So today, magre-reply na naman tayo sa ating mga masugid na subscribers. So itong video na to guys, ay requested ni Sir Marcos Teves. So sabi niya dito, "Hello sir, any update po sa DMC ngayon? What is your insight today? Thanks in advance." Okay guys, so kung ready na kayo, stay ka lang. I'll show you how. Bago tayo magsimula, inaanyayahan ko muna kayo na i-subscribe itong ating channel para maging updated ka sa mga bagong videos na lalabas. And also, huwag mo na rin kakalimutan na i-like itong ating video para marami pang potential investor ang maabot itong ating channel. And samahan niyo ako na pataasin natin guys yung less than 1% na nag-i-invest dito sa ating bansa. Okay? Ako sa first disclosure lang guys, mayroon akong ownership sa DMC, no? So today, on September 30, 2021, meron na akong unrealized gain na 101.12%. And also guys, kung viewers kayo ng ating channel, in last 9 months ago, talagang nagbenta na rin ako ng ibang shares ko dito sa DMC, no? Kaya kung mapapansin nyo guys, dito sa aking portfolio tracker, 4.2% na lang ng aking portfolio ay na kay DMC. And again, ito ay hindi recommendation na bilhin nyo rin itong DMC guys, no? So pag-aralan nyo muna guys bago nyo bilhin itong company. Okay, so tignan muna natin yung pinaka-latest na financial report ng company, which is yung second quarter earnings report. So guys, kung titignan natin dito, the company reported a strong second quarter result with improved earnings and revenue and profit margin. So yung kanilang revenue guys na nakuha sa kanilang second quarter result ay nasa 29.8 billion pesos. Tumaas siya ng halos 153% compared to the previous quarter of 2020. Now, kung titignan natin dito naman guys in terms of net income din, yung kanilang net income na nakuha ngayon ay nasa 5.23 billion pesos. Tumaas din siya ng halos 269% compared to the second quarter of 2020. Yung profit margin ngayon guys ng company in the second quarter of 2020 result ay nasa 18%. Tumaas naman siya no, compared sa second quarter of 2020 na nasa 12% lang. So yung increase guys ng profit margin sa kadahilanan na tumaas yung kanilang revenue. Okay guys, so hahanap tayo ng pinaka-latest na news and disclosure sa DMC. So, kung titignan natin dito guys, Inquirer.net, no, on August 20, 2021, so dito pinublish na DMCI mining profit surge on record nickel ore shipments. Okay guys, so sabi dito, DMCI Mining Corporation's profitability surge during the first semester of the year after recording about a 400% increase in its net income to 1.2 billion from 241 million in the same period last year. And also guys, kung titignan natin dito, 3.7% na kanilang revenue ay nanggagaling sa nickel mining. That's a good and positive sign. So dito guys, nakikita natin na umi-increase talaga ng significant yung kita ng company sa kanilang nickel mining. And also, sabi din dito sa report, this is the first time that both our mining assets are operating at full capacity. We expect shipments to remain strong in the second half since we were able to extend Berong's mine life from June until the third quarter this year. And also, DMCI took advantage of the uptrend in nickel prices. The average selling price went up to $44 per metric ton from $27 per metric ton. This is owed largely to China's robust stainless steel production and strong demand for electric vehicles in which nickel is considered a vital raw material. And also, dito sinasabi din na magkocontinues yung uptrend ng nickel prices. So that's a good and positive sign para sa kanilang business. And isa pa na nahanap natin na latest news and disclosure ng DMCI. Kung titignan natin dito guys sa Business World, so ito ay pinublish noong August 24, 2021. So dito sabi sa report, DMCI Power allot 3.5 billion for Masbate, Palawan plants. Ayon sa sabi dito sa report, DMCI Power Corporation, the off-grid unit of listed conglomerate DMCI Holdings Incorporated, is investing around 3.5 billion to develop two off-grid projects with total capacity of 27 megawatts in Masbate and Palawan. In addition, in a regulatory filing on Monday, DMCI Holdings said majority of the amount or 2.7 billion will go to the construction of 15 megawatt thermal power plant in Nara, Palawan, while 800 million will fund the development of a 12 megawatt hybrid solar diesel power plant in Masbate. In addition, the target commercial operation of the 12 megawatts plant in Palawan is first quarter of 2022, while the 15 megawatts in Masbate is set to go online by the second quarter of 2023. So in addition to the report, these investments are in response to the government's mandate to accelerate the exploration, development, and utilization of renewable energy and indigenous fuel resources, thus decreasing our dependence in imported fuel. Okay, so maganda guys, na nakikita natin na nagsishift yung kanilang power segment sa renewable energy. So that's a good and positive sign para sa akin, no, as an investor ng company. So 5.9% na kanilang revenue ay nanggagaling sa kanilang power of grid. So that's good and positive sign sa kanilang revenue, no? Okay, so let's see in the end of 2021 kung ano yung mga additional report na ibibigay ng company. So ang titignan natin dito guys, yung latest transaction ng mga insiders. So Assistant Treasurer and Director recently bought 5 million worth of stock. On the 12th of August, Maria Cristina Gutianon bought around 854,000 shares on market at roughly 5.86 pesos per share. This was the largest purchase by an insider in the last 3 months. Insiders have collectively bought 431 million more in shares than they have sold in the last 12 months. And in September 17, Assistant Treasurer and Director recently bought 4 million worth of stock. On the 5th of September, Maria Cristina Gutianon bought around 586,000 shares on market at roughly 6.83 pesos per share in the last 3 months. They made an even bigger purchase worth 30 million pesos. Insiders have collectively bought 538 million more in shares than they have sold in the last 12 months. So this is the latest transaction ng mga insider sa DMC. Okay guys, so kung titignan natin dito sa fair value versus current price ng DMC, so nakuha kong fair value ngayon, no, in terms of my current valuation, nakakuha ang company ng 12.37 pesos per share. So dito guys, clearly ang company in terms of my valuation, undervalue ang company. And also in terms of my future valuation naman, nasa 11.14 pesos per share yung aking nakuhang fair value. Samantalang sa Peter Lynch valuation, o sa Peter Lynch value, nakakuha ang DMC ng 6.74 pesos per share. Sa Graham Formula, nasa 11.98 pesos per share. And sa DCF ay nasa 6.15 pesos per share. Yung ilo-long term ko itong company, unless ma-reach ng company yung fair value ko na 12.37 pesos per share. Okay guys, so hanggang dito na lang muna yung pagre-review natin sa ating requested video ngayon or requested stocks. So maraming salamat sa nag-request ito, Sir Mark Steves. This is Pessy Warrior guys na nagpapaalalang invest wisely and see you on the other side. Maraming salamat sa panonood. So if you want to expand your investing knowledge, make sure na nakasubscribe ka and pindutin mo na rin ang bell button para ma-notify ka sa mga bagong videos na lalabas dito sa ating channel. And once again, this is Pessy Warrior na nagpapaalalang invest wisely and see you on the other side.